Would you please help me with this ginkgo tree my husband gave me? We've had it for 3 or 4 years. It doesn't look happy now and did the same thing last year. It has had plenty of water, sun, and I like this one, love.
Yeah.
But the leaves turn yellow and start falling off in June. One lower limb died and I removed it. Please help me save my tree. I love your show. Thank you, Ms. Phyllis. We appreciate that. And we're going to try to help save your tree. So what did we think about that, though? We thought a couple of different things after looking at that picture.
I think there's several things probably going on. And when I get like a question like that, you kind of try to read a little bit between the lines.
Mm-hmm.
And this was a gift from her husband. Is
right.
that what I
this
got
is correct.
From it?
This is correct.
So she's probably trying to take really, really good care.
Oh, yeah.
And sometimes we tend to overdo. And it could be that she's overwatering some.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That, you know, that maybe then ginkgos don't like wet feet, as
right.
we talked
That's
about.
Right.
They
right.
like well-drained soil.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
You know, if a plant is not doing well and the canopy doesn't look well, you really want to look at the roots.
Uh-huh.
That's
Good
where the problem is. If you know there's been no chemicals, you know there's not a mechanical thing, you look at those roots. Watering will tend to kill roots if it's too much water.
Right.
And when we looked at the base of that plant, it looked like that there were some roots exposed.
Mm-hmm.
And it looked like some of them may tended to curl around.
Uh-huh.
So it may be that, number one, it's not planted deep enough.
Right, which is what I, yeah.
Yeah, and because and there's mulch around it, so you pull the mulch back, there's still going to be roots exposed. So she needs to probably look at that.
Okay.
And then to also pull the mulch back, pull the soil back, and see if there are any circling or girdling roots.
Mm-hmm.
Because if that plant was held for several years in a container in a nursery, as we all know, plants, the roots tend to girdle
yes,
or circle around the pot, and if you don't tease those out when you plant it, they will continue to want to girdle and go in the circle
right.
instead of going out into the existing soil and setting down a really, really good root
and
system.
And I can actually see that, too, because, look, it's only been 3 or 4 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a young tree.
Right.
Right. That's probably been sitting in a nursery. Yeah.
So I would look at that root system and what she should do if that is a problem.
Right.
You know, she should pull that plant out of the ground and pull those roots apart and then plant it back at the right depth. And because she's doing that now in the heat of the summer, she really needs to stay on top of, you know, taking care of that plant and not letting it dry out. But don't overwater. Don't just saturate it on a time schedule. Do it as the plant needs it.
Okay.
You know, and a lot of people say, I got to water it. So it's been a week, so I need water. Well, some plants don't need water in every week, especially if it rains.
Right.
So, and ginkgos are very, very slow growing.
Yes,
you know?
They are.
Yeah.
Very slow.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. They're an interesting plant, too, so.
Right. Yeah, we wish her much success.
Yeah.
Walt, anything you wanted to add to that?
No, I think everything is pretty much spot on. I did have a question to ask Dr. Kelly about it also. When you see the roots are all bound in a pot, is it okay to cut some of those roots off?
Okay,
I thought.
Yeah,
okay.
It is. And if you do that a lot, I mean, if you got big old roots, try to unwind the bigger roots, and you can prune those back.
Okay.
Try not to prune any of the, like we talked about, the feeder roots.
Okay.
And if you do a lot of extensive pruning on the roots, it might not be a bad idea to prune that canopy back some, so that the root system is more in balance with the canopy.
Yes.
Okay.
Makes
sense.
Hope you enjoyed the video. We would love to get more questions from you, so be sure to leave us some comments.